In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
This week at the conference here at Roehampton University. But now, on behalf of the province of England and Wales, I want officially to welcome you to England and to our province. It is wonderful to see so many of you, members of the International Society and family, gathered together here at Roehampton. I know that all the members of the join with me in saying that it's a great happiness and privilege for us to have you with us to celebrate our very special feast. We welcome with love our RSCJ sisters from Australia and New Zealand, from Japan, Korea and India, from Mexico, Peru, Brazil and Colombia, from Canada and the United States, and from Ireland, Scotland, and France. We are delighted to welcome collaborators and friends from Australia and New Zealand, Canada, United States, and of course our own colleagues and alumni and the network of schools in our country. The network of schools, of course, includes our celebrant, Proper Robert, who is from Uganda, so he's another country that we can mention. And from our provincial administration, both our office and our Duchesne House over the road. Some of our children from the primary school across the road have provided the decorations here, so they are with us too in a very special way. We are particularly privileged to welcome not just one or two members, but the whole of our General Council from the road. And especially our General, Sister Kathleen Conan. We won't breathe a word of this luxury to our colleagues. I'm sure that you have already begun to experience the family atmosphere, chatting to one another, some of you visiting the schools, different parts of London, and the university, and have been greeted by your England World's hostesses, whom I also welcome and thank for their involvement in these days. I think people have been very excited to be able to welcome so many people. It's so appropriate, I think, that we are celebrating here at Roehampton, so close to where Janet Stuart lies buried, as we begin these days of pilgrimage and reflection in her honour. As we enter into this Eucharist, let us ask for her motherly blessing, and know that she celebrates with us, glorifying with us the Sacred Heart of Jesus.
And just say also a very warm welcome. I'd like to welcome you to this celebration. It is wonderful on this great feast of the Sacred Heart. The thoughts of his heart last through every generation, that he will rescue them from death and lead them to life. Let's begin by acknowledging God's love and mercy, God's kindness that has gathered us here together. Let us say, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We shall say the opening prayer together. God, our Father,
If the Lord set his heart on you and chose you, it was not because you outnumbered other peoples. You were the least of all peoples. It was for love of you and to keep the oath he swore to your ancestors that the Lord brought you out with his mighty hand and redeemed you from the house of slavery, from the power of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Know then that the Lord your God is God indeed, the faithful God who is true to his covenant and his graciousness for a thousand generations towards those who love him and keep his commandments, but who punishes in their own persons those that hate him. Him he makes them work out their punishment in person. You are therefore to keep and observe the commandments and statutes and ordinances that I lay down for you today. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
accept the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal them. Come to me, all you who labour and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I think you know that it is the custom on the Feast of the Sacred Heart for religious of the Sacred Heart to renew their vows. And so I would ask the religious of the Sacred Heart to stand if you can and to join with all our sisters around the world who are renewing vows today. And we say in the name of the Father,
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
trust
me in the fidelity of God, and love my sisters.
I renew with all my heart the vows which I have made to follow Jesus Christ in the society of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, by perpetual obedience, poverty, and chastity. And I commit myself anew to our mission of manifesting the love of Christ by the service of everybody to stand, the whole assembly, as we renew our Christian commitment. And we say together, O God,
the source of our being and the goal of our longing, we commit ourselves to cherishing your word and seeking your face, not only in the sacred places, but also in the midst and on the margins of daily life. O God, embodied in human life, we believe and trust in you. We commit ourselves to the challenge of opening our hearts to your love and sharing that love with others. O God, life-giving spirit of healing and comfort, of integrity and truth, we commit ourselves to struggle against evil and injustice and to choose life.
When I was preparing this reflection, I recalled that when I was a teenager, my mother, like all mothers, would give me a pep talk before I went out with my friends, which went something like, be home by 11, don't talk to strangers, remember to say please and thank you, and so on. Mothers have done that all through the ages and still do. But as we left the house, she would shout down the hall, remember who you are. Remember who you are. Come to think of it, she still does that 40 years later. And I took that phrase, remember who you are, to be an additional reminder to behave myself, because as a member of a certain family, with all the responsibility that that entailed, I had to behave myself. And when I reflected today on the readings and on what this feast means, I couldn't help feeling that it is about reminding us who we are before God. Beloved children of God, beloved sons and daughters of God. Israel, in the first reading, is told, if the Lord set his heart on you and chose you, it was not because you are none than other people, you were least of all peoples. No, it was for love of you that God called. It was for love. So this feast reminds us not only who we are before God, but it also reminds us of who God is. God has set God's heart on us, chosen us, not because of anything we have done, or who we are, or where we come from, or how good we are, or anything, but simply for love of us. For God's love, we're told, is unconditional. And the experience of being loved unconditionally, for most of us, I suspect, is a rare gift, but one for which we all thirst and long. When we have felt the experience of deep loving, we know how that affects us. Our self-esteem increases and we flourish and blossom. Our capacity for creativity takes off, and the clouds and shadows of our life no longer frighten us in quite the same way. When we discover the immensity of God's unconditional love for us, it is at once, I think, awesome, glorious, astonishing. And if I am honest, it is also, for me, at sometimes terrifying, difficult to grasp, and hard to believe. But there is a God who loves me with no strings attached, with an absurd compassion which nothing and nobody can take away from me, is incredible. We cannot earn a love that we already have. We cannot lose a love that is unconditional. I suspect, like most of us, I've grown up negotiating love in my life, testing the limits of love and being tested, imitating, adapting, conforming, rejecting and being rejected, trusting and being trusted. And while everybody here will have flourished because of the joy and strength that comes with being deeply loved, we also all bear the scars and wounds of, at times, feeling unloved, betrayal, abandonment, brokenheartedness. We have learnt our loving conditionally. And the joy of God is the constant invitation to believe that we are loved, each one, for our own sake. And this simple but amazing truth may be difficult for that wise and learned part of us to absorb. And it is only when we have the open heart, simple faith, and the receptivity of a child are we able to receive it. And so we might pause and ask ourselves on this feast of the one who is love, what in me and in my life prevents me from hearing and believing that I am beloved of God? What stops me hearing the words addressed by God to me every day for love of Him? The struggle to know ourselves loved by God is becoming a central theme in the teaching of Pope Francis. Again and again, he's taught of how it is harder to open our hearts and let God love us than it is to love God in return. It is more difficult to allow ourselves to be looked upon by God than to look upon God, to be encountered by God than to encounter God. And one of the great gifts of Pope Francis is that he is helping us to reclaim our sense of the tenderness of God. And that word tenderness he uses a great deal. He wrote on this day last year that the Lord knows the beautiful science of caresses. He does not love us with words. He comes close and gives us his love with tenderness, even in the smallest things. And this is a powerful love, because closeness and tenderness reveal the strength of God's love. And we have today a beautiful image of that tender love of God. If you look on the back of your masterpiece, there is an icon. It is an image resonant of John, the beloved disciple, with his heart on the breast of Jesus. But the figure could be any one of us. And for each one, the image will speak. But it is an image of being drawn close, an image of intimacy and listening. Listening to the heartbeat of God, the rhythm of God's love and presence in our lives. Constant, strong, steadfast. Listening to the pulse of blood pumping life and energy around the body, giving purpose, a purpose which impels us beyond ourselves to others. And it represents, I think, a quiet resting in God's embrace, where no words are needed save the knowledge that we are held in the heart of God, each one. And in the background are those very beautiful words, Je te fiancerai à moi dans la tendresse. I will betray you to myself in tenderness. Words taken from the book of Hosea in the Old Testament. I will betroth you to myself forever. Betroth you with integrity and justice, with tenderness and love. And tenderness and love, integrity and justice, are words that remind us that we can only claim God's unconditional love as our own by blessing others with that same love and grace. The only way to love God is to love others, especially the poor and especially the vulnerable. And we all know that it was Madeline Sophie's desire that the steadfast love of God, which was so central to her own life, would be at the heart of the mission of her little society. And all her life, she strove to ensure that people knew that they were loved, especially children and the young. And we all know, too, that today the society continues with that mission, to manifest and make known the love of the heart of Christ, the love of God. And all around our globe, in favelas and slums and schools and colleges and clinics, in numerous places where we, as RSCJ and our collaborators serve, that mission continues. And we can go on doing this, living this mission, because of the fidelity of God to our little society, and because of the love of one another. Because we know that our one security is God's love. A love that is tender, constant, strong, and steadfast. A love that calls forth from us the same kind of love in response. And it is always, for me, a wonderful fact of this feast that all around the globe today, there will be people gathering to do just as we are doing, remembering, celebrating, committing ourselves anew to being faithful to the challenge of opening our lives and our hearts and sharing the love with others. I cannot finish without mentioning the other celebration and the reason why many of us are here, which is to celebrate with the province of England and Wales the centenary of Janet Stuart. And the reason I mentioned it is because Margaret Phelan, the general archivist, has brought with her to England the profession cross of Janet Stuart for these celebrations. It was the cross worn by Janet Stuart until her death in 1914. And we refer to it at times as the missionary's cross, because it Anna de Lucia, who was on her way to Chile to make the first foundation of the Society of the Sacred Heart in Latin America. And Chile had just celebrated 160 years of that foundation. And Reverend Mother de Lucia wore that cross until 1879, when she gave it to Mère Céleste Dumont, who was leaving for Europe, saying, "C'est la croix de la missionnaire." It is the missionary's cross. And the cross was entrusted to Janet Stuart, who gave it to Mabel Digby. And in August 1901, Mabel Digby gave the cross to Janet Stuart for her own use, as Janet Stuart wrote, "For my wife." And she instructed that on her death, that cross would go to the Mother House with all the history. I think that cross, in some ways, is an appropriate symbol for today's celebration. And at the offertory, Margaret will bring the cross to the altar. RSCJ, on the day of their profession, received a cross. Our cross is already smaller than the one Janet Stuart's. But we hear the words, "Receive this cross, symbol of the tender and faithful love of God for you." And it reminds us that of God's unchanging embrace at every twist and every turn of our life, reassuring us that we are never alone, that there is nothing that cannot be healed or forgiven, and that with the arms of God around us, there is nothing that cannot be achieved. And those three great women, Janet Stuart, Anna de Lucia, Philippine Duchenne, along with many other great women, exemplified that. They each spent their lives opening their hearts and responding to the tender and faithful love of God. And it took them across frontiers and borders, literally, over mountains, across seas, around the world, for the love of the mission. So this cross binds us in time and space as a global family, from our very beginnings to our present and beyond into an unknown future. So sisters and brothers of many nations, let us go on celebrating today, remembering who we are before God and who God is in our lives. A God who is love, a love that is constant, tender, strong and steadfast, and which calls each one of us to live out of that same tenderness and with integrity and justice.
Now the time for our prayers of intercession.
Australia, New Zealand, Belgium, France and Netherlands, Brazil, Colombia, India, Ireland, Scotland, Japan, Korea, China, Malta, Mexico, Peru and England, Wales. We hold in our hearts all RSCJ around the world, who are with us in spirit as we
We pray for the world. We pray for those overburdened by poverty, violence, war, conflict, and unrest. May they experience a loving God who shares their burden. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our Sacred Heart friends and colleagues. As the chapter of 2008 reminds us, you encourage us to continue to walk in the way of Sophie. With you, we try to listen to the heartbeat of God and the reality of our world. Together, let us continue to strive for a world where no one is excluded and each one has a rightful place. Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for those in leadership roles within the church and civil society. Give them the strength and courage to speak with compassion and act with justice. May all the decisions be rooted in gospel values. Lord, in your mercy.
Yes.
We pray for all the young people we come in contact with. We remember the words of Janet Stuart, that we prepare them for the future. May they be deeply rooted in the values of truth, justice, and love. May they become agents of change in our world. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Now is the time for the offertory procession. Son, Jesus, filled with love for us. Because of his love, accept our Eucharist and forgive our sins, granted through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Loving, all-powerful, and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lifted high upon the cross, Christ gave his life for us. So much did he love us. From his wounded side flowed blood and water, the fountain of the sacramental life in the church. To his open heart, the Savior invites all to draw water in joy from the springs of salvation. Now with all the saints and angels, we praise you forever. Sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, gave it thanks, and gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Proclaim the word of your love until he comes again. we offer you the bread of life and the cup of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the Paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son Jesus, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, all women and men who minister in your name, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our sisters and brothers. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them true after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your faith and in the resurrection. Give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with Janet Stuart, with Philippine Duchesne, with Sophie Barra, and with all the saints we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. And we say together, through him and with him and in him, O Lord, together as one family, let's say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Let us now pray together in prayer for peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Thank you.
Lamb of God. big thank you to all who have prepared this wonderful celebration before we close. I'm not so sure if there are any notices. Yes, at the very end. So what we are going to do is to say the last prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, may this sacrament fill us with love, draw us closer to Christ your Son, and help us to recognize him in others. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And let us go in joy and peace to celebrate this
feast. Now, strawberries are a particular lump.
have stories.